Hurricane Erin has speeded up, so it's going a little faster now to the north-northwest. Also, it's going to strengthen up throughout today. It's going to go all the way from 98 miles per hour. It's going to strengthen up to 104 and then get all the way towards a low-grade, potentially a low-grade Cat 3, high-grade Cat 2, 109 miles per hour, showing it's going to stay steady at that pace because it's going towards the cooler waters. It's going to suck that up when it upwells, and it's going to help weaken it down because it's going to grow as it slows down. Now, there is some new information, so I'm going to go through that as well. And you can see you still have the tropical storm warning for North Carolina and the tropical storm watch going across Virginia and towards the Delmarva. Now, we still have Invest 99L out here in the MDR. I'm still showing that's not going to amount to anything. It's going to get maybe a tropical depression, then it's going to weaken down because the dry air is going to unfavorable environment, everybody. And we still have this wave that's still sucking up with this dust as it goes through towards the Leeward Islands. Now, the waters over here are a little bit cooler because of what Erin did, but it's still, if the sun hits it, it's going to strengthen right back up. And as it goes past that cool spot, it's where you could get maybe a tropical depression, maybe even a tropical storm as that turns out by the high pressure. So that still could be some wind effects towards Bermuda potentially, and maybe some rainfall towards the Leeward Islands. We'll go through that as well. Now you can see that Hurricane Erin is fighting off that dry air and it is trying to intensify. So it's getting some good outflow while it's trying to strengthen up, and it has some strong little vortices inside, so it is trying to intensify. And you can see this right here, it does have some thunderstorm growth. It is trying to intensify as this goes around Hurricane Erin and trying to close off that inner core. And you can see this as it moves forward, that is really trying to intensify, is bringing a thunderstorm growth. It still has a little bit of dry air in there that is going to combat the whole time. So it's going to be a little bit slower of an intensification period. Got a new update for this morning. So the latest update on Hurricane Erin, it is moving north northwest at 13 miles per hour, maximum sustained winds of 100. Storm surge did go up a little bit as well, to 1 to 3 feet, did go across Delmarva and a little bit into southern Jersey. While everything else is still the same, 1 to 3 feet for the rivers, 2 to 4 feet along the outer banks of North Carolina, and 1 to 3 feet going into South Carolina. Now you can see here from the latest microwave imagery that the eye of Hurricane Erin is trying to close, but it's having a really rough time on the western side. So with that, plus the upwelling from the cooler waters and the shear hitting it from those westerly winds, is going to keep it somewhat at bay, everybody. We could see a little bit of intensification still, where it could be a high-end Cat 2, a low-grade Cat 3, and you see here that it starts dropping dramatically once it hits with that westerly wind. And the Euro shows the same thing as well. As a matter of fact, if you look at the 0Z and the update that we just got, it shows the exact same location. So the impacts that you have forecasted for your area will be the same impacts later on. Now, the latest update on the impacts with Hurricane Erin, you can see right here with the Euro, showing you can get up to that 50 miles per hour wind gusts. The latest update this morning shows those wind gusts could get a little bit stronger, but it's in the same vicinity of the high 50s to the high 60s is the area that you can get right here along the outer banks of North Carolina. Still showing you can get to 50 miles per hour wind gusts right along the coast of Delmarva going towards Jersey Shore, and maybe a little bit of 60 in there as it pulls away and gets further away from the northeast. Now remember, everyone, you're not going to have 100-foot waves. You're not going to have 20s all along the seaboard. It's going to be the 10 to 15 still cushioning towards North Carolina, and it's still stretching a little bit towards Virginia, towards Delmarva and southern Jersey still, where y'all can get up to 12 to 15 still. So remember, these links are in the description for you to go see for yourself and zoom in where you're at on your wind gusts, also on your wave height. We even have an update on your wave height going all the way towards South Carolina, showing right here from Wrightsville Beach all the way towards Myrtle Beach is where it goes from that 12 to 15 feet possible, but it starts going down from that 10 to 12 feet. It will be further offshore. The biggest waves is still hitting towards northeastern North Carolina. And you can see what's coming next, everybody. So you have disturbance one. This one is at 10% in the next 48 hours, 60% in the next 7 days. This is the one that could bring some rainfall towards the Leeward Islands. Potentially, as it goes out through the Atlantic, you could get some tropical depression, maybe even a low-grade tropical storm once it gets past that cool spot, and maybe bring some wind or some rain impacts towards Bermuda. Still showing no further impacts than that. And we have over here Invest 99L. It's at 40% chance in 48 hours, 40% chance in the next 7 days, showing that you could get additional development over the next day or so while the system moves westward at around around 15 miles per hour, and a short-lived tropical depression could form. By the end of the week, environmental conditions are expected to become unfavorable for further development. So this is going to come by Friday and Saturday, and as we go from Sunday into Monday is where it's going to make that northward turn, and as you go 6 and 7 days out, you see it just weakens down and heads to north. No further development, everyone. It is going to run into that pocket of cooler waters that did get hit up by Erin. But once it passes that, that's where it has chances to go right back into warmer waters again and maybe strengthen back up and have some impacts on Bermuda. But you can also see here from the hurricane analysis forecast system. Now you can see this with precipitable water. But you can see over here for that next system that as it goes by the Leeward Islands, as you go Thursday evening into Friday, all the way towards Puerto Rico as well, could bring you some rainfall, 1 to 2 inches of rainfall, so you need to watch out for that as it heads further toward north and then maybe start strengthening up once it gets into warmer waters again, showing that the winds will not be towards the Leeward Islands. It will not get formation fast enough, but the winds could go around towards Bermuda after that, after it tries to form something up. The Euro is not seeing any kind of formation out of that, maybe a very weak tropical depression for a moment, but nothing else out of the next wave neither. When you look at GFS, it takes something weak while it gets past a cooler patch of waters, but then it gets into the warmer waters again and maybe get a tropical depression or a tropical storm as it goes by Bermuda. It's trying to show a hurricane. It's still a little far-fetched on whether it gets that strength or not. You can see with the GEOS satellite showing that it will be either a tropical depression or a tropical storm, maybe as it goes way far northern to the Atlantic, maybe get all the way up towards a hurricane status. We will see. It's going to be fighting sheer and dry air, so it is going to have problems along the way. Showing by the ensembles that it has a pretty weak chance. Most of them show that it does have a chance to turn out. You can see that here. We have one ensemble going towards the west. That would be the outlier, everybody. Look at Weather Next Generation, also agreeing on that northward turn, and the experimental model, also agreeing on the northward turn. Showing as it goes by Thursday into Friday, that's where it tries to get some kind of upper level low. Maybe it goes all the way down towards the surface, but you can see all that dry air entrainment still getting into Invest 99L. It's hindering that one. The next wave coming through is having issues as well. While this maybe gets there by Saturday, tries to form something up if it can fight the dry air, and then it just gets pulled apart between a high pressure swinging this around, the trough coming through with the shear. It just pulls that system apart. The Euro shows that you could get a little bit of rainfall, maybe a half of an inch. When you look with the GFS, which shows the worst case scenario, you might get an inch or two inches in the red, showing as it goes by towards Bermuda, you could get an inch or possible a little more than that. And when you look with the winds, you can see the winds are not there for the Leeward Islands. It could be potentially towards Bermuda, and Euro is not showing the winds neither. It's showing a sharper turn. So that's the latest information, everyone. I didn't want to tie up too long of a video. I just want to give you the latest information so you can go about your day. Hope you have a very great day today. Please be aware of the beaches. I know a lot of places the beaches will be closed. Other than that, have a very great day today, everyone. Be safe. Just enjoy life in general. That's what God makes you to be. Happy, be merry, just enjoy life. Remember, there's always going to be good times and there's always going to be bad times as well. Just get through them and just enjoy life, everybody. Be merry. A quick word from our Father before I go. Ecclesiastes 7:14. In the day of prosperity, be joyful, but in a day of adversity, consider. God also has set the one over against the other to the end that man should find nothing after him. Amen. In the good times, be merry, be joyful. In the adversity times that you have, be joyful and be merry, because that is just life. God makes it that way. There's going to be good times. There's going to be hard times. And try and be joyful and merry through both of them, everybody. Expect them and just get through them. Have a very great day today. I might see you for an update this afternoon. I hope God blesses every single one of y'all and brings a very merry heart to every single one of y'all today and peace in your home. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everyone. Be safe. Stay off the beaches.